know that scene in Star Wars where a young Luke Skywalker steps out from his uncle's moisture farm and looks up across the horizon at the breathtaking dusk of his solar system's two suns, safe in the confines of his home planet of Tatooine before old R2 and C-3PO came and messed everything up? Yeah, well, have you ever wondered what our home planet would look like with those same solar mechanics? Would it just be another excuse to take twice the sunset selfies, or would there be a bit more to it? Well, yeah, as you may imagine, this is life's biggest questions, and of course, not everything is as it may seem. Let's find out. Hello, Internet, what's going on? And once again, welcome back to the most inquisitive channel on YouTube, Life's Biggest Questions. As per usual, I'll be your disembodied floating voice, Jack Finch, as today we curiously ask the question, what if our solar system had two suns? Roll the clip. I get chills every time. But for the curious amongst you, that clip was, of course, from 1977's Star Wars A New Hope, depicting perhaps one of the most iconic overtures in cinema, and of course illustrating just exactly how a binary sunset would appear. Obviously, it allows us to visually represent the exact mechanics of our solar system hypothetically having two suns, but I mean, it's also one of the greatest scenes in cinema, so any chance we get, we're gonna show it. Anyway, let's forget about Tatooine for the moment, because instead of detailing a galaxy far, far away, let's bring things back down to the comfort of the Milky Way. And to begin with, you know what is insane. The answer to this question might already be much more grounded in reality than what we first imagined. In some cases, although it's not a widely accepted theory, several scientists believe that our solar system already has two suns, or has had two suns. Wait, what? And yeah, it is as terrifying as it sounds, potentially, anyway. Back in the early 1980s, scientists noticed that the mass extinction events on Earth seemed to fall in line with the same cyclical pattern. These mass extinctions seemed to occur more frequently in ancient history, roughly every 27 million years. You see, it was strangely accurate. This in turn led researchers to turn to astronomical events for some kind of an explanation. Now, it is very important to note that this is very much a fringe theory, but the substance of Nemesis is still worthy of taking a look at. In 1984, Richard Muller of the University of California, Berkeley, suggested that a red dwarf star situated 1.5 light years away from our solar system could be a brown or white dwarf, or a low mass star several strokes as massive as Jupiter. But the thing is, all of these explanations would cast a dim light, in other terms, making Nemesis incredibly difficult to spot by astronomers. In relation to the correlation of Nemesis and these mass extinction events, scientists have speculated that the potential second sun may be affected by a region of our solar system known as the Oort cloud. This area is made up of icy rocks in a portion of space that lies beyond the range of Pluto. Now, to cut a long story short, it is theorized that Nemesis travels through the Oort cloud every 27 million years or so, kicking out a load of extra comets from its sphere, and in turn sending them hurtling towards the inner solar system and thus the Earth. Goodbye, dinosaurs. You know how that story goes, right? Now, it's important to note that Nemesis is very much a fringe theory, and its existence is not supported by any kind of credible evidence, but instead only theoretical models. However, it does lead to an idea of what our solar system would be like with two suns, because the point is, any sort of sun is without a doubt an incredibly powerful solar body, and for any kind of binary star systems to exist, one of them needs to be more powerful than the other. Gravitationally speaking, of course, because in 2017, a study suggested that nearly all stars like our sun were born with companions. Now, part of this study detailed evidence of young stars born in the Perseus molecular cloud, of which they frequently appeared to be twinned during their binary creation. In fact, it seems that pretty much every star born in the galaxy are born in pairs. In fact, our nearest neighbor, Alpha Centauri, is not just a binary system, but in fact, a triplet system. There's three of them. In this respect, the likelihood of our sun having a companion, and thus our solar system having two suns, starts to become much more likely, and the existence of Nemesis frighteningly becomes a reality. However, scientists who support this theory are pretty confident that if Nemesis did exist, then it disappeared millennia ago, breaking apart from our sun's binary gravity and disappearing into the murky cosmos to live its own life deep within the Milky Way, never to be seen again. So long, and thanks for all the asteroids, I guess. It would explain why astronomers have yet to find find direct evidence of Nemesis's existence and seemingly give us less cause for concern about the terrifying potential of the Oort cloud, you know, because that's a whole different story. You see, the possibility of us ever witnessing a sunset similar to that of Luke Skywalker on Tatooine is pretty much impossible. If any solar system has two suns, then they would have to be far, far outside of the other's orbital influence for things to even get to the point of harboring life. Also, if we applied this hypothetical situation to our solar system, right this second, life on Earth would be pretty much impossible. With two suns, day and night would have completely different meaning. During the day, it would be hellfire, nights would be staggered and inconsistent, and thus, seasons would be relatively impossible, if you could call them that. In short, you know how the answer usually goes. Life on Earth would end pretty quickly. Sorry, guys. In fact, the incomprehensibly powerful gravitational waves caused by two suns would make it nigh impossible for any planetary bodies to ever form. With two suns in relatively close proximity, the surrounding solar system would be a violent and impossibly chaotic environment. Only planets on the fringe of their orbital influence would be able to exist, and if we applied two suns to our solar system, the only feasible planet to survive would be Pluto, which, come on, isn't a planet at all, but it would have to step back up to the plate in this regard. Come on, Pluto, we're all counting on you, little buddy. So yeah, there we have it. The most interesting facet to this question, in my opinion, is the possibility of the existence of Nemesis. In that respect, this question is no longer a hypothetical, and our solar system potentially already has two suns, or in the more likely case, had two suns. The truth of it is that we still have so much to learn about the nature of our universe, and the formation of stars is an integral proponent of that. Our universe really is a place of wonder. Let's just hope Nemesis isn't planning on hitting that Oort cloud anytime soon, right? Yeah, fingers crossed. Well, there we have it, our long and short answer to the question, what if our solar system had two suns? What do you guys think? Do you agree, disagree? Have any more intriguing insights to add? Then let us know your thoughts down in the comment section below, as well as any choice picks of your own. Before we depart from today's video, let's first take a quick look at some of your more resounding remarks from over the past few days. First up, the theatre guy says, let me guess, we'd all die. I mean, yeah, you're not wrong. Hey, what can I say? We handle a lot of apocalyptic themes over here at Life's Biggest Questions. It goes without saying at this point. I'm sorry, guys. I really am. Well, I'm sad now, so on that note, unfortunately, that's all we've got time for in today's video. Just stick around all the way until the end. If you were a fan of this video or just Life's Biggest Questions in general, then please be a dear and hit that thumbs up button, as well as that subscribe bell, and I'll be seeing you in the next one. As per usual, I've been your disembodied floating voice, Jack Finch. You've been watching Life's Biggest Questions, and until next time, you take it easy.